peace education, education about culture of peace, of tolerance at kindergarten, elementary schools, high schools, universities are absolutely critical. I have read a lot over the years about the phenomenon of extremism, of terrorism. And one thing I learned, and I believe this to be one of the most important critical factors in contributing to extremism, is the brainwashing, miseducation by irresponsible mullahs, teachers in Madras, in Pakistan, Indonesia, many other countries, where from childhood individuals who are supposed to teach love, compassion to children, they begin to brainwash them about the West, about Christianity, about Jews. I was traveling once from Paris to New York, and I read the newspaper, which most of you probably have heard, Le Monde. Very good, one of the best daily papers. And I was horrified to read a story. The story was Dateline Amman, Jordan. The journalist was quoting, that was many years ago, 15 years ago, and I still remember, quoting some individuals off the street. The way they talk about Jews, not only about Israel, about Jews in general, because you have Israeli Jews, you have American Jews, French Jews, and so on, all over the world. But they will talk about Jews in general. It's just abominable. And why would they talk like that? Well, some maybe they have direct experience with Israel occupation, West Bank, Gaza, and so on. But most probably not. It's through the brainwashing of them. Some argue about terrorism and poverty. Well, I would say very little relationship between poverty and terrorism. Because if this were to be the case, you'd have the whole sub-Saharan Africa engaged in extremism and terrorism. Because no continent anywhere in the world suffer more, were more humiliated, abused, and used than Africans south of Sahara. From slavery, European colonization, partition of Africa, colonialism, the Cold War, where billions of weapons were dumped on Africans and then abandoned when they were no longer strategically important. If and impoverished, and yet you travel throughout sub-Saharan Africa, you don't feel the hatred towards Europeans, towards white, or anyone. So there is no correlation. Because if anyone, anywhere in the world, were to hate the Europeans, would be black Africans. So it is very little correlation. Of course, extreme poverty is fertile ground for extremists to manipulate, particularly when the poor, the extremely poor, are also uneducated. And then if there are influential mullahs in the community, yes, then they are susceptible to engage in extremism. So education is extremely important. Human rights education, peace education must be in the curriculum of at least two elementary school. I'm not a great intellectual. I don't enjoy my work as president. I get bored in the office. So I spend time writing children's stories. And the first booklet was published, well, a few months ago, completely sold out. The second edition is this one in several languages, published by UNICEF. It tells the story of a crocodile because that's the big animal of East Timor and a boy. And it is a series that I'm writing for television and for radio. A boy, a crocodile, a girl, and a dolphin. They travel the world, and through their travels around the world, they spread the message of peace, of tolerance, because as they travel the world, they encounter different civilizations, different cultures, different peoples. And finally, they arrive back in what Timor is today. And the island of Timor is born from a crocodile. Because if you look at the map of Timor, it looks like a crocodile. The legend of Timor is that it was a crocodile that gave birth to the island of Timor. So this booklet goes to school children to start teaching them about, of course, environment. The dolphin represents clean environment. Their encounter of cultures is to teach our children generation about the richness, the wealth of different cultures, of different religions, how we must respect and accept each other. So that is absolutely critical. Education, starting peace education at elementary level. So it means peace is, there are no shortcuts to peace. You have to work over a long period of time. And will we ever achieve peace in the world? Permanent peace? Well, I'm afraid I don't know whether that is a realizable dream or not. Next question. This would be a long, long answer contained in a book. I don't want to subject you to a Fidel Castro type speech of 6-7 hours long. But to make it simple and incomplete necessarily is they often, or many times, or sometimes, nations go to war because of prejudices, misinformation, fear. Sometimes, even within communities around the world, they go to war with each other because of prejudices. Well, you know, one of the most tragic example is the persecution of Jews throughout history. In Europe, in particular, over centuries, why Jews were persecuted, discriminated? Because of ignorance, prejudices, ignorance about a people. If people were to read about the rich Jewish history, their culture, they would be impressed. But because they don't read, or they read only false propaganda by certain groups, you have this prejudice and hatred towards the Jews throughout history. then leading to the Holocaust in the 40s. In other areas of the world, within communities. But sometimes the fight is more of over concrete things, like boundaries or water. People fight over water, and maybe in the decades to come, some of the larger conflicts in the world will be over water. So there are many reasons. Some strategic miscalculations. World War II, when Japan went to World War II, over strategic misconsideration, miscalculation for resources. Believing that the best way to supply Japan with unlimited resources is to invade and control most of Asia. When today, the thinking in Japan and similar countries that need resources is we build friendships, we build bridges, we invest, we buy the resources, rather than physically invading and occupying. But 50 years ago, 100 years ago, the Europeans did the same. Went to Africa, Asia, to occupy land, because that land was a good base supply of materials. Today, the Europeans, 50 years ago, began to free themselves of their colonies and continue to receive the resources from these colonies in a much more just and fair manner, or intelligent manner. So there are many different reasons. And what is important, I believe, in the various communities, because that's what we try to do in my own country, to look at boiling problems, developing problems in a community, and address them in a preventive fashion before people start really fighting over